Eastern Canada has vast tracts of farmland ideal for livestock grazing. And to make the most of it, Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada research scientist Yousef Papadopoulos is developing new grass and legume mixtures that can turn ordinary pastures into grassland that beef cattle can't wait to get at.
Over 58% of the acreage in Canada can grow grass, but can't grow anything else. So it's a tremendous power for productivity. And what we would like to do, we want to utilize these resources that cannot be used for any other agricultural product and make the best out of it. We can grow forages, good productive forages, and while sustaining the quality, and also not only quality, quantity.
The beef trials at the Nappan, Nova Scotia farm will run through 2016, with performance and quality evaluated for the best growth results.
We identified the top four mixtures, and we put them in combination with two different legumes. And we divided this pasture behind me into those different mixtures. That means we have eight mixtures. This forage has the balance of the fiber as well as the good quality, like the protein, the sugar, that has high energy content.
Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada research biologist John Dinesfeld, a specialist in animal nutrition and grazing, is seeing good fat and marbling quality in his test results.
Getting the degree of finish, getting the marbling and the back fat there is one of the bigger challenges to achieve, and you know, we are finding some mixtures seem to have definite advantages in that regard. Well, every one of them is actually would have sufficient back fat to make an A quality grade, and their marbling would be at least a single A, and a lot of them are into the double A, triple A degree of marbling.
The goal is to provide beef producers with improved profit margins. Papadopoulos knows the research can be a source of better sales. With pasture as a feed source for finishing cattle, beef producers are not as dependent on expensive grain as a feed supplement.
Now these grain is very expensive to purchase. So for beef farmers, especially in Eastern Canada or many other region, this is getting to be the cutting away from their profit. They are looking at every outcome from research we have, and we have a quite popular annual field day, because our farmers really want to know. They look at our pasture, they say, look, this one looks a lot better than I have. So what do you have there? How can I duplicate it?
Grass-fed beef is getting a good reputation for quality, says Dinesveld.
There's a very growing demand from the consumer market standpoint for grass-fed beef. There's a lot of interest, and it's something that it appears we can do quite well here in Nova Scotia and in the Maritimes.
Dinesveld says the pasture grass approach is not for everyone, but there are advantages in lower costs and new sales opportunities.
In many ways, it's a lot easier to feed animals in the barn because a lot of your conditions are less variable from day to day. But the costs are also much higher. So with a pasture finishing scenario, you have a lot less infrastructure cost, and you know, you can potentially get these market premiums that are out there as well. So it has, you know, the opportunity is there for producers who are willing to take on the management to make this happen.
Beef producers in the region are aware of the research and showing an interest in the progress of the project.
They're ahead of the curve. They've got types of grasses that maybe we'll all start using in a couple of years. I mean, that's what I'm looking at. We're looking at, okay, if we're going to renovate it, pastures that we've got at home, what should we put in it? It's no good for us to put in what we've always put in, because they're not working right. So, a place like Nappan provides us with the information that we're going to need and when we have to make those choices. So it's very, very important. For us in the Maritimes, we need to find a way to use forage. We need to find a way to use grass and clovers and so on, because that's what we've got here. That's what we can grow. So that's what's going to be the future. So anything that pushes that future forward is what we need to have.